With so many more media outlets and social media channels, you hear so much more in the way of science words and weather words. Some are a little weird, some are strange, and some are historic, like polar vortex. Even though it might seem new to you, it actually is an old phrase to describe air that encircles the Earth around the pole way up above our heads. And what it does is when it meanders, it allows Arctic air to head south. So that's your polar vortex. It just seems new, but it's really not new. How about this one? Haboob. Sounds a little weird, doesn't it? Well, that actually is a real word with Arabic origins. It's been used in the Middle East for centuries, and it simply means sandstorm or dust storm. Those are really common in the desert southwest of the United States. Superstorm. You remember Superstorm Sandy. Well, the problem with superstorm is there's no one definition for what it is. So it's really up to the opinion of the person using it as to what constitutes a superstorm. Now here's one, fire rainbow. That is a misnomer. In other words, it's a bad name for something that really does happen. But what happens is you see what's part of a halo. It's known as a circumhorizon arc beneath the sun, but you see it in cirrus clouds. It's not raining and there's no fire. What about monsoon? That one people confuse with typhoon, and you know a typhoon is the name for a hurricane in other parts of the world. Well, a monsoon is simply a shift in the wind that allows a lot of warm, moist air to flow in a certain season, and it's basically a rainy season. So the desert southwest has a monsoon season. Pyrocumulus, that sounds kind of cool. It's a real meteorological word. It is a cumulus cloud formed by fire. Whenever you have large fires burning foliage that gives off a lot of moisture, you can build a cumulus cloud on top of it. That is a pyrocumulus. El Nino, that one's been around for a couple of decades, but El Nino is simple. That is when the central and eastern Pacific Ocean get a lot warmer than average, and it shifts weather patterns around the world. It's not necessarily a bad thing, depending upon where you live. In some places, it could be a good thing. Bomb cyclone, that sounds scary. Well, cyclone is a storm, and bomb is a meteorological expression that means it loses pressure very fast. In other words, it strengthens very fast. It loses 1 millibar of pressure every hour for 24 hours. And we typically see this as a nor'easter, or in other words, it's a winter storm. What about firenado? Well, firenado is a nickname for something that's been known for decades as fire whirl. And it's simply when you have a large fire, it pulls in air from different directions, begins to spin. It looks like a tornado, but it doesn't form in any way the way a tornado forms. Supermoon, we hear this pretty frequently now. Again, it's a scientific word known as perigee moon that now people say supermoon. It's really not super. It's a little bigger. It's a little brighter. But it comes around every so often. So there are all sorts of things on Earth, some of them real, some of them misnomers, but stay in the know. I'm Chief Meteorologist Alan Seals.